Hi folks, Lance here from TriggerShims. In this video, I'm going to show you how easy it is to install our TriggerShims shim kit and a Wolff reduced power shooters pack in an SP101. Now all the Ruger double actions are about the same. This could be a Super Redhawk or a GP100 and all the procedures will be the same. Now we've watched the Ruger teardown video. We've got our trigger assembly out, our hammer, pin, main spring, and strut. We're going to start with the main spring and replace that with a Wolff reduced power spring. Now I've got a block of wood. I've drilled a 3/16 by 3/8 deep hole. We're going to use that to hold the strut while I replace the main spring. And that's all there is to that. Next, we're going to take the guard latch pin out. We'll depress the guard latch and with a small punch push the latch pin out. Set that aside. Now there's your trigger guard latch. Trigger guard latch spring or the trigger return spring. Trigger guard latch plunger. Okay, next we're going to turn our attention to the transfer bar. And we're going to pull back just slightly on the trigger so that we can release the transfer bar. We'll set it aside. Okay, next we're going to take the pawl, the cylinder pawl, and it has a plunger and spring that's set right underneath here. We're going to lift it, pull back on the trigger. Now you see where the pawl the pawl plunger sets. We're just going to hold our finger over there a little bit. I'm going to pull the pawl out. We're going to pull the plunger and spring out. And that's released all the tension off of our trigger assembly now, so it's just free. Next, we're going to remove the pin partially and install a shim. Now I want to show you here on the shims, when you get a shim, these are stampings that I stamp out, and you will have a little bit of a rough edge on your shim. What I do is I take a fine hone and I just work that rough edge off a little bit if there's any burrs on there, and you can feel it when the shim goes smooth, you've honed it enough. And that's all there is to it. Make sure that those are nice and smooth when you install them. Now, I slid the trigger pin over about halfway. I'm going to set a shim in. And then pushing back up from the bottom, I slide the trigger pin back in. I'm going to do the same thing to the other side. There we go. Now I wanted to do that without any springs or anything in place so I could feel that and make sure that we don't have any binding. When we install those shims on either side of the trigger, we want to make sure there's no binding and that it's nice and free. And it is. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and put our Paul plunger back in. Paul plunger and spring. I'm going to take our Paul. Set that back in place like that. Now I'm going to hold on to the trigger right here, and I'm going to pull back on the pawl, make sure that everything's nice and free there. We don't have any binding. Now we're going to pull back on the trigger just enough. Now if you pull back on the trigger very far, what's going to happen is you're going to let that pawl plunger escape. So we're going to pull back just enough that we can set the transfer bar back in. Okay, there we go. Now the next thing we're going to do, we're going to install our reduced power trigger return spring, or our guard latch spring. We'll start, we want to look in here, make certain that the trigger link is in place, and that runs into this hole right here, and I can see it down through there. We're going to take the plunger. There's our original spring. We're going to get our reduced power spring and our trigger guard latch. Now you notice this little flat spot on our trigger guard latch. That flat spot has the flat has got to be up so that when we insert the pin, that pin goes in on that flat. Holds that latch in place just like that. Now that trigger guard latch is also your trigger return spring through that link, and by putting reduced power spring in there, it takes some of the weight off of the trigger. Okay, there we've got the trigger assembly completely back together. We've got two shims, two trigger shims, and a reduced power spring. We've got a reduced power hammer spring. Now the only thing left to do, we want to fit our hammer shims in our frame and make sure there's no binding there. So what we're going to do, we're going to take a little grease, just a little bit, and put down here on our hammer. That's going to make those shims stick like it's glue. To that hammer. I'm going to line that shim up with my pin. Do the other side. Squeeze them in place there. Line them up with your pin. I'm going to take our frame. Set our hammer in place. From underneath, we're going to take our pin. Trust me when I say this is easier to do when you don't have a camera sticking in your face here so you can see what you're doing. There we go. Okay, now I've got two shims, one on either side of the hammer. And I can check the hammer and make sure that it's free and there's no binding. And we're good to go there. And go ahead and take this back out. There's our two shims. And that's it. Now you go ahead with your normal reassembly. When you get your trigger guard latch put back in your frame, your trigger guard assembly put back in your frame and latched in place, and put your hammer in, then is when you go ahead and make sure your shims are lined up. Close everything up and you're good to go. Take care, good shooting, and God bless.